हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू इंजीनियरिंग वर्ल्ड। टुडे आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग विद माय नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ रॉकेट साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग। एंड करंटली आई एम डूइंग द हिस्ट्री ऑफ रॉकेटरी। एंड सो फार आई हैव मेड 2-3 वीडियोस, यू कैन चेक दैट आउट, इन विच आई हैव डिस्कस द अर्लियर टाइम पीरियड्स ऑफ द हिस्ट्री ऑफ रॉकेटरी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टाइम पीरियड 1957 टू 1961, दैट वॉट हैड हैपन्ड इन द फील्ड ऑफ रॉकेटरी इन दिस पीरियड। सो देर वॉज अ कोल्ड वॉर विच वॉज गोइंग ऑन बिटवीन अमेरिका एंड द सोवियट रिगार्डिंग द रॉकेट डेवलपमेंट। एंड this got accelerated when Soviet launched Sputnik 1 into orbit on October 4, 1957. So it was the first vehicle which was put into an orbit around the Earth. Okay, and this satellite was launched by Sergei Korolev, who was a very important person for the Soviet space program. Okay. And his identity was always kept as a secret. Even the people with whom he worked known him as a chief engineer. And he finally died in 1966. Until his death, his identity was kept as a secret. So you can imagine that how important he was for the Soviet space program. America had a fear that with the launch of Sputnik 1, Russia could start nuclear war against America, but the Soviets started a space program to develop the better intercontinental ballistic missiles, okay, which is also known as ICBMs. So that they can perform better in the war. But this person, Sergei Korolev, have realized that it could be used as a spacecraft, okay, because these rockets can carry some sort of machinery along with it into outer space, like satellites. So it can be used as a spacecraft. In November, Soviet launched Sputnik 2. And it carried a dog, first animal into space called Laika. Now this was all about the development in Russia. And what about the US? The US started with their unsuccessful attempts of Vanguard. Then they finally launched Explorer 1 on Jupiter C rocket in 1958. It was their first satellite to be sent into space, and its aim was to study the radiation cover around the Earth. And this satellite discovered the Van Allen radiation. So there were three people behind this project, and Van Allen was one of them. So it was named after him. The other two persons were William Pickering and Werner von Braun. Werner von Braun was the same person who worked for the Hitler, but after the World War II, he was captured by the Americans and taken over to America, where he started working for the American Army. Okay, in 1958, then they successfully launched the Vanguard rocket. This satellite is still orbiting around the Earth, although it is powerless and not functioning at the moment, but it was the oldest satellite which we can see in the Earth's orbit. This satellite showed us that the Earth has an asymmetrical shape. It is of a pear shape with the small end of the pear at the North Pole. Now in 1958, NASA was formed. In 1959, Soviet launched Luna 1 spacecraft. It was the first spacecraft to reach the escape velocity of the Earth, and it went quite near to the moon. It was only 5995 km away from the surface of the moon. So it went that much near. So this was Luna 1 was the first spacecraft to go beyond the Earth atmosphere. So it escaped the Earth's gravitational pull and went into the outer space. So it was launched in 1959, and Luna 2 actually reached the surface of the moon, but unfortunately it crashed and this Luna 2 is famous for discovering the solar wind by using sensor which were fitted in the spacecraft that can detect ions. Okay, and it also confirmed that the moon does not have a magnetic field. Then Soviet launched Luna 3 that actually orbit around the moon and sent us the pictures of the moon. Okay. In 1960, that was a great year, and many satellites which were sent into space were used for weather forecasting. Satellite TRIOS 1 was sent for television purposes. It is used for television weather satellite. Okay, now first communication satellite ECO 1 was also launched. Sputnik 5 took two dogs, Strelka and Belka, along with it, and they were safely returned back to Earth. In 1961, April 12, Soviet cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin became the first person in the world to went into the outer space in the spacecraft called Vostok 1. So its journey took 60 minutes in total, and Vostok 1 was a derivative of R7 ICBM. So ICBM, I have already explained you, it's intercontinental ballistic missile which can be used for a spacecraft, and this spacecraft was attached to this ICBM that took Yuri Gagarin into the outer space, and this rocket burned kerosene and liquid oxygen as a propellant. On May 3, 1961, Alan Shepard became first American to go into space in Freedom 7, and the rocket they used for this purpose was Redstone rocket, which was developed by Wernher von Braun. This person I have already explained in my previous video that he was a German. He worked for Hitler earlier, but after World War II, American took him to their own country and he started working for them. And this rocket, Redstone rocket, burned alcohol and liquid oxygen as the propellant. Okay, so this is all for today. I'll continue with the history of rocketry in my further videos. And guys, if you do like my videos and you find my videos informative, so please share my videos, like it, and subscribe my channel. I'll see you next video. Till then, thank you. Bye.